Dear students, welcome to BISET video lecture series for the subject Elements of Civil Engineering. Myself, Raina Shukla, Associate Professor, Civil Engineering, LD College of Engineering, Ahmedabad. Today, we will discuss about transportation module. In this module, in previous lectures, we have discussed about role of transportation in national development and major four mode of transportation, that is roadway, railway, waterway and airway. We are starting in this session from the component of airways or the component of airports, that is loading apron. Apron is the paved area adjacent and in front of the terminal building. It is used for loading and unloading of contents of aircrafts. Minor repairing and fueling and checking of aircrafts is carried out at loading apron. Boarding and unboarding of the passengers is carried out at apron. This is Y-shaped apron which you are finding along with the terminal building. Number of aircrafts are parked surrounded to that for loading unloading activities. This is pier or finger system, straight shape of the apron. Next component, that is hangar. So as I have told you that the landed aircraft from runway through taxiway goes to parking area, that is hangar. It is an enclosed area for housing, storing and repairing of aircraft. Nose in parking in hangar. This is enclosed hangar area, accommodate more than one aircraft. So this way from hangar, it comes out through taxiway, will go to the runway. Radar. Radar is a component provided on airport for safety and guidance to the pilot. The aircraft enters in the range of radar, is identified, is guided. Communication with pilot is possible once it is detected its entry in the radar range. Unwanted entry of aircraft can also be recognized by radar. Beacons are the lights, light beam, strong beam of light of white and green color, and generally they are rotating slowly at 6 revolutions per minute. By presence of beacons, pilots within aircraft can identify location of airport. Visual aids like lighting is provided on runway, taxiway, on airports. Red light in front of the aircraft as the center line of the runway is giving indication of presence of another aircraft from same or opposite direction or can enter or cross. So it is guiding the pilots. Airports observed in Gujarat, there are total 14 number of airports. At Ahmedabad, international airport is there. Bhavnagar, Surat, Vadodara, Rajkot, Porbandar, Jamnagar, Bhuj, Disa, Diu, Kandla, Keshod, Radhanpur, Amreli. These are the 14 locations of airport in Gujarat. From those 4 having no airline service, and 9 are the active airports. Directorate General of Civil Aviation is managing aviation activity. DGCA is responsible for implementing, controlling and supervising airworthiness standards, safety operations, crew training in India. So where the airport should be provided, of which category should be provided, what should be the standards for pilot, what can be the types of aircraft permitted at any airport, training, etc. all is guided by DGCA. Their recommendations are there. For air traffic control, ATC tower is provided. They are located in terminal area to supervise, direct and monitor traffic at the airport during takeoff and landing. Air traffic control tower is provided with approach control facilities. They have markings, pavement markings, lightings, beacon lights. Control towers, as the aircraft approaches the runway ground, will tell the pilots to tune to the tower frequency. The pilots then check in with tower, citing their position and their designated holding point. When safe to do so, the tower controller gives the aircraft permission to line up on the runway for landing, providing there is adequate spacing ahead. Since the last departure, the controller can then give the aircraft clearance for takeoff. This is control tower, inside view of the control tower. These are the references for waterways and airways. In previous lecture, we have seen about waterways and in this airways. Now, in this next session, we are discussing about introduction to road traffic. Traffic, everyone is observing it, is a big problem. Road and traffic. Traffic is that element of transport system which involves the travel of discrete units having characteristics of independence, randomness and human control. There are basically major 4 elements involved in traffic operation: human being, road user, driver of the vehicle, pedestrian, pillow rider in case of two-wheeler, passengers of buses are the road user, the vehicle, the roadway and the environment. And the combination of these 4 elements makes scenario for the traffic on roadway. Traffic engineering is the branch of engineering which deals with planning and geometric design of streets, highways and abutting lands with traffic operation, which gives safe, economic and convenient transportation of passengers and goods. Study of traffic is required to solve the problems generated by traffic. The study is included in traffic engineering. Human being, road user, their behavior. Road user characteristics are categorized as physical characteristics, psychological and mental characteristics. In physical characteristics, there are certain which are temporary and some are permanent characteristics. Psychological characteristics like motivation, intelligence, learning, emotion, individual differences, reaction time, shows psychological behavior of human being in traffic stream. Psychological characteristics, in addition to those, are attentiveness of the driver, fear of the driver if he is in he or she is in learning stage. Enjoy, impatience, motivation are the psychological factors which affect human behavior. Mental characteristics like knowledge about the situation, scenario, skill, driving skill, intelligence, experience makes the man perfect. More experienced driver behave good way in congestion, in more traffic. Literacy, that helps them to read the instructions, follow the instructions. Maturity of the driver, that's why under 18 are not allowed to drive the vehicles. Immaturity may not permit them to be a good driver. Temporary physical characteristics which affect the human behavior as a driver, as a pedestrian, as a passenger in the traffic stream, which is generally temporary effect under the effect of alcohol, drug, stress, workload, anger, fatigue, illness. Driver behaves in traffic stream, that is temporary physical characteristics. Permanent physical characteristics, these are more important. These characteristics are studied properly. Based upon that, geometric design of roadways are carried out, which helps them, which guides them to provide the components, the geometric design elements as per the limitations and efficiency of human being. Vision, hearing, strength and judgment power. Vision, the visual factors that is related to the visual acuity. Human being's eye make some definite cone of vision with their eye, which can again vary from person to person. At the same time, it can vary with the age, with the time. Say if this is the angle, it makes cone of vision. This cone of vision, 3 degree to 5 degree, 5 degree to 7 degree, 7 degree to 12 degree, is giving medium satisfactory to the best vision. If any object comes in the cone of vision, cone of acuity vision, vision of acuity, then that object can be identified very well. And then safety measures, reaction to the situation can be given prompt. Peripheral vision of human being. We can say human being can see horizontally, can see vertically, from top to bottom, from right to left. But again, that peripheral vision cannot be extended up to 0 to 180 degree perfectly from right to left without movement of neck. Whichever peripheral vision is permitted, that only make driver safe in the traffic stream. Eye movement and visual concentration take some fraction of time, fraction of minutes, seconds, to judge the situation, to identify the object. So concentration should be towards the front path along with limited peripheral movement or vision. To identify the color, that is color vision. to permit the vision under the effect of glare. Say if we are entering in tunnel or take exit from the tunnel. So light to dark, dark to light. Human being is affected by the glare. In glare, vision is affected. They need some definite time to recover the glare. So what should be the general average time for glare vision and glare recovery? That should be taken into consideration for design of tunnel or the adjacent development to the tunnels. Judgment of time and space. Say at what speed the vehicle is coming from back or from front. What distance between two vehicles? Back to back, back to front, collision. Depends upon judgment of time and space. So till this we have seen road user characteristics, that is physical, psychological, mental. In physical, temporary and permanent. In permanent, vision, hearing, judgment power. Hearing supports disability or limitation of the vision. Vision is supported by hearing. If someone is sounding horn, we are able to judge that some vehicle is coming from backside. We are either giving him way or we are accelerating and moving away from the space. Bus coming from backside, then by hearing we can, without movement of neck, without eye movement, we are able to judge that bus is coming, truck is coming. So that is advantage of the hearing. The second factor is the vehicle. So as such, we have seen the human being behavior as road user characteristics. We see about the vehicular characteristics. Vehicular characteristics are categorized as static characteristics and dynamic characteristics. In static characteristics, we are considering dimension of the vehicle, that is length, width, height of the vehicle. We are considering height of driver's seat, height of headlight, and the space below chassis as static characteristics. Self weight of the vehicle, live load of the vehicle, dead load of the vehicle, the load of axle load. That is also static characteristics. Maximum turning angle. That is vehicular characteristic. In dynamic characteristics, we are observing when the vehicle is in motion, when the vehicle actually behaves in the traffic stream. That is speed of the vehicle, acceleration of the vehicle, brake, air brake, fluid brake, mechanical brake, that affects the braking performance. Engine capacity, horsepower required to overcome air resistance, wind resistance. So by study of static and dynamic characteristics as vehicular characteristics, we are able to define certain criteria for manufacturing of the vehicles, and we are also able to judge the scenario of the traffic and performance of different category of vehicles in the traffic stream. The static characteristics, vehicular. The third element of traffic, that is roadway. In traffic, we are finding various problems. So it is a combined effect, combination of the road user behavior, vehicular characteristics, existing roadway condition, and the fourth element, environment. If riding quality is not good, the vehicles cannot move at desired speed. Less the speed, more occupancy of the space for longer time on the roadway, which results into congestion. Top surface, type of pavement, whether flexible or rigid, condition of road, whether good, bad, poor, maintenance of road, regular and periodic maintenance of road is required. If it is not maintained, pre-monsoon, post-monsoon, then there can be the cracks, potholes, and different damages observed on the roadway. So potholes are giving discomfort to the user. At the same time, it make compulsion to the driver to retard the speed, to decelerate the vehicle. Speed retardation, that means more travel time. Geometric design of road, if it is proper and as per the norms, then vehicle can move easily on the roadway. Road user becomes safe and traffic can be the stable. Improper geometric design leads to uneconomy, leads to uncomfort to the user. It also reduces safety. Drainage of road. There is surface drainage and subsurface drainage. If drainage of road is not efficient, rain water will accumulate on the road surface, which will not allow the vehicular movement or the vehicular movement at the lesser speed. Then it may cause various problems of traffic. Fourth element, environment. In the prevailing environmental condition, climatic condition, weather condition, human being along with their vehicle on the prevailing roadway behaves. If heavy rainfall, temperature is high, snowfall on the roadway, more cold in winter, fog and mist which affect the visibility, prevailing wind. These are the environmental factors which affects the traffic. Snowfall. Yesterday in newspaper we have seen about snowfall at Penisevilla and number of heavy vehicles, more than 50, collide with one another. Lots of damage to goods, more than 70 persons injured, 3 died. That is the effect of adverse environmental condition, heavy snowfall. So that affects the traffic severely. Problems of traffic. Congestion, accidents, noise pollution, air pollution are the major problems of traffic. You find traffic jam scenario. Queues of vehicles. Number of vehicles stacked on the roadway. They are not emptying the space of the roadway, occupying space. They got delay. Their travel time increases. Their mental status is disturbed due to time wastage in traffic. At the same time, they cannot reach to their desired location in time. Bottleneck formation of the traffic. Accidents. Road accidents, air pollution, health hazards, noise pollution is also, these are the problems. Now we have seen the major four problems of the traffic. These major four problems ultimately tends to indirect impacts, increase in travel time, reduction in speed, more delay, wastage of fuel, number of times acceleration braking, maintenance cost of vehicle increasing, clutch, brake wire, maintenance cost increases, life of vehicles decreases, mental status of the human being affected, then their work performance, efficient work performance is affected. To study the traffic, we have to study parameters of the traffic. Mainly three parameters, density, volume, and speed. We are able to study these three parameters and we are able to plot relationship between these three parameters and we are able to judge the traffic scenario other than existing one. Also, we are able to graphically present the existing scenario. Traffic volume, which we are knowing as flow. It is the number of vehicles passing a given point during a specified period of time. That is measured in number of vehicles per hour. At a particular roadway location, in an hour, what number of two-wheelers, three-wheelers, four-wheelers, bus, trucks, light commercial vehicle, heavy commercial vehicles we are observing, that is known as traffic volume or traffic flow. Density, it has a relevance with the distance. It is the number of vehicles occupying a unit length of moving lane of a roadway at a given instant of time. That is number of vehicles per kilometer. Speed. In traffic engineering, we are measuring different speed, different types of speed. Time means speed, space means speed, lower limit, higher limit, geometric design speed, median speed. Speed is expressed in kilometer per hour and it is the rate of movement of traffic. It is the distance covered in unit time. To explain the traffic, we are finding out time headway and space headway. By taking inverse of the measured volume, we are able to find out time headway. And by taking reciprocal of the density, we are able to find out space headway. Or by videography survey, we are able to find out distance between two vehicles, gap between two vehicles that is related to space headway. And after the movement of one vehicle, next vehicle moves at what time? That is time headway we are measuring. If the traffic congestion we are observing more, then we are checking it with the capacity. Whether the road is capable to take this much traffic or not. If the traffic is beyond the capacity, then we are able to justify the suggestions, improvement suggestions like introducing new lane, widening of the roadway, provide parallel tracks, diversion routes, provide bypass, ring road, introduce expressway. So capacity is the ability of a roadway to accommodate traffic volume. As per highway capacity manual, three types of capacity: basic capacity, possible capacity, and practical capacity of the roadway. The traffic which we are defining as number of vehicles. So if I want to define traffic in number of vehicles, My definition is long. X number of two wheelers, Y number of cars, Z number of bus, etc., etc., all. To avoid all these things, we are expressing traffic volume in passenger car units as per the Indian Road Congress recommendation. We are using the multipliers with which number of vehicles are multiplied, and we are finding those number of vehicles of different categories in a single unit, say PCU. By summation, we are getting final PCU to define that traffic. Two-wheeler is multiplied, number of two-wheelers is multiplied with 0.40 or 0.50, and we will get number of two-wheelers in PCU. Cars, number of cars are multiplied by 1, and we will find number of cars in PCU. Sum both, PCU of two-wheeler, PCU of car. This way for all vehicles, and find out the traffic in a one single unit, passenger car unit. To study the traffic in traffic engineering, different surveys are defined. Classified volume count survey, spot speed survey, what is travel time, which type of delay occur. There are two types of delay, fixed delay and operational delay. At a signalized intersection, if we are waiting for some seconds, then it is fixed delay. And along the route, due to congestion and different operational problems, if travel time is increases, speed is reducing, number of times stop for 5 seconds, 10 seconds occurs, number of times speedometer indicates 5 km per hour, 10 km per hour speed, that is operational delay. The starting point of the trip is known as origin. The ending point of the trip is known as destination. That is OD survey, origin and destination survey. Study of traffic flow parameters and their relationship, that is in traffic flow characteristics and studies. Parking survey. Parking is causing more problem to the traffic. Vehicle enters into the traffic and taking diversion for parking. From parking lot, vehicles merging into the traffic stream. Improper way parked vehicles are affecting the traffic. Insufficient parking space cause occupancy equal to the vehicle space on the roadway. Number of accidents, causes of accidents, suggest the improvement measures, suggest the remedial measures to reduce number of accidents. That is in accident survey. Accident cause social burden, economic loss, and the fatal accident cause serious health and social problems. Pedestrian survey. Pedestrian as a road user. More number of pedestrians, more disturbance to the moving traffic while crossing the road, while walking along the roadside. Then what about safety of pedestrian? At the same time, what should be the facilities for pedestrian and to avoid the ill effects of pedestrian movements on the moving traffic? Different surveys are carried out. On roadside, traffic volume count survey is carried out manually. This is also manual method. They can use mechanical counters also. Here they are making the tallies, means entry of first vehicle, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5th one. This way they are counting moving traffic, number of vehicles of different categories. Number of surveyors are required in the volume count survey. In India, we are finding heterogeneous traffic, multimodal vehicular traffic sharing the same road space. Find here non-motorized vehicle, slow-moving vehicle like bicycle, tricycle, pedestrians, heavy commercial vehicles, three-wheelers, cars. So it's a heterogeneous traffic. Origin and destination survey. The methods for this are the roadside interview survey, license plate method, written postcard method, tag on vehicle method, and home interview survey. The data which we are collecting during OD survey are origin of the trip, destination of the trip, purpose of trip. Purpose of trip can be the work, education, market, shopping, hospital, temple. Purpose of trip can be different. Generally, work trip and education trips are regular trips. Another trips are irrespective of the time and location, and they can occur at any time as per the conveniency of the user, conveniency of the prevailing traffic scenario. They can be carried out during off-peak hours also, but the work and education trips are time bound. Also, they are on fixed routes. Number of passengers, number of stops, along with the reasons, travel time, travel route. These are the data collected in origin and destination survey. In parking survey, inventory of space available for parking is carried out. Space offered for parking is studied, measured. Supply of parking lot is found out. And what is the demand of space for parking is checked. Category wise space for parking, say number of space available for two-wheeler parking, number of space available for four-wheeler parking. Say if four-wheelers are more than the capacity and if they are parked in this space allocation for two-wheeler, then capacity will be occupied by the four-wheelers only. And number of two-wheelers accommodated will be double compared to the four-wheeler as per the static characteristic of the vehicle. Ill effects of improper parking. Problems with the traffic due to improper parking is studied in parking survey. Accident risk during entry and exit of the vehicle in parking lot. There are major way two types of the parking, on-street parking and off-street parking. On-street parking, which is carried out on adjacent to the roadway and it is very near to the destination. Off-street parking may be away from the destination. Some minimum walking distance may be there in off-street parking. On-street parking are parallel parking, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree angle parking. Angle parking is convenient for entry and exit in the parking bay. Maneuvering space requirement is lesser and merging, diverging into the traffic stream become easier. Off-street parking can be provided on ground on different floors, that is multi-floor parking, multi-story parking, can be on terrace, can be in basement and underground. It can be free parking, can be the paid parking. So this is two-wheeler parking. It is off-street parking, underground parking, multi-story parking. Find the number of cars parked at different story. Covered parking, maybe paid parking. So this is angle parking. Easy to get entry into the parking bay, and same way exit from the parking bay. This is on street parking, on the side of the roadway. That is also known as curb parking. From the edge of the roadway, curb parking. Two wheeler and queue of the car you are finding as on street parking. This is off street parking, away from your destination. Nearby railway station we are finding off street parking. After the parking, we see the next survey, that is accident study. Accidents, which are also including collision, minor accidents, major accident, major which involve visit to hospital, some treatment, orthopedic problem, fatal accidents which result into death. In some accident, there is no injury, only damage. Damage to the vehicle, damage to the property. Vehicle may overturn. Slipping of vehicle, skidding of vehicle. So these are the different types of accidents which cause loss and damage of passengers and goods. What are the causes of accidents? Human error. Improper road geometric design, unmaintained condition of road, poor riding quality, overloaded vehicles, pedestrians moving with less care, excessive speed, rash driving, projecting load from the vehicles, without control, railroad intersection, unmanned railroad intersection, advertisement, exhibition on road sites, eye movement and eye concentration cause deviation from the driving and cause accident. Weather condition like fog, mist, snowfall, dust, rain. Stray animals like cow, monkey, dog observed on the roadway. Tire may burst, brake failure, headlight not working, etc. etc. are the causes of accidents. Accident record is available in nearby police station. Even to claim the insurance, police complaint is a must. And to resolve the dispute or to put a claim, accident must be reported in the police station. They are maintaining the record by preparing location files. They are also making the spot map, that is on the map of the roadway and area is plotted as per the location, different categories of accidents. If at a location we are finding more the spots, we are declaring it as black spot. By the first visit on the site of accident and not to scale, some graphical presentation is carried out to clear the scenario of the accident site is known as collision diagram. And with his actual measurements, environmental condition, physical condition, we are preparing the graphical presentation by using some scale is known as the condition diagram. So if some improvement suggestions are supposed to give, then by study, prepare the condition diagram and suggest the remedial measures or the improvement suggestions and find out the cause of accidents. through condition diagram. What are the preventive measures of accident? We know we cannot avoid accident. We cannot remove the accidents, but we can reduce the accidents. So they are categorized as engineering measures, enforcement measures, and education measures. Engineering measures are the measures which are carried out at the manufacturing level of the vehicles in vehicle design and in geometric design of the roadway. By enforcement, that is, make rules, regulations, decide the fine, collect the file, take help of the traffic police, and enforce the situation. By education, make traffic children park, make the future drivers aware about the safety in traffic stream from childhood, make documentary film, slogans, advertisement on TV and radio, posters, traffic week celebration, awareness programs are the education measures to prevent the accidents. In traffic engineering, by conducting traffic surveys, we are finding out the scenario of the traffic. Say, if we are conducting classified volume count survey on the roadside, then we are able to find out total number of vehicles during peak hour on the roadway. If we are finding that it is more than capacity of the roadway, then we can give them improvement measures. At a particular location, if we are finding more number of accidents, then by study of that location, we can suggest the improvement measures like introduce divider, median, segregate the traffic, provide footpath for the pedestrian, provide separate bicycle track if you are finding more of the non-motorized vehicles. By roadside interview survey, we are taking the drivers on request in an interview bay, and then by asking different questions, we are finding out the problems related to the traffic and what can be their probable solutions. That also is possible by conducting different traffic surveys. If we are finding insufficiency of the parking area, then we can suggest different measures like park and ride. Do not use vehicle for making your regular trip. Use public transportation. If public transportation is efficient, available in vicinity to your home with minimum walking distance from your destination, same way from your home or you are from origin, then you will attract it to use it. But if it is not so, then you need some space for parking of the vehicle. That way you come by vehicle from the home, park there and board into the public transportation and conduct the long trip. And this way, use of personal vehicles can be, private vehicle can be reduced and public transportation can be appreciated and problem of congestion can be solved. But then again, we require efficient public transportation system. So in this session of introduction to traffic, we have seen about what is traffic, which kind of study is carried out in traffic engineering, what are the different surveys by which data of traffic can be collected, and to suggest reaction time for geometric design of the highway, what are the road user characteristics that we have seen, the four basic elements and their characteristics, that is road user characteristics, vehicular characteristics, environmental and roadway, that we have seen in this session. Thank you.